In this problem, we're trying to find an expression for velocity as a function of time using our variables v, g, d, mu, and m, which is the mass of the particle. And for a small spherical particle with a diameter d that falls in standard air at a speed v, the drag is given by 3 pi mu v times d, where mu is the air viscosity. So the first thing we can do is we can draw a picture. So here we have our particle. And the force downward is the weight of the particle. And it's opposed by the drag force. And so we write this and the sum of the forces equals mass times acceleration. So MA equals W minus 3 pi mu dV. So where does velocity and time come into this? Well, we can rewrite acceleration as dv dt and our weight as mg minus our drag force. So now let's rearrange so velocity is on the same side as its derivative and t is by itself. So dv over g minus 3 pi mu little dv over m, by the way, I'm doing this, equals dt. And you should look at it and realize that because you have a dv over v, you're going to end up with some kind of exponential function. So we need to integrate both sides, and the easiest way to do this is to let u equal that mess on the bottom, v over m. Therefore, du dv equals minus 3 pi mu d over m. So we can rewrite dv equals minus m 3 pi mu d du. So now let's do our substitution. So this will make it a little bit easier. So on the left hand side, we're going to have du over u. On the right-hand side, we're going to have minus 3 pi mu d over m, basically just taking out that constant, dt. So we haven't changed the right-hand side of our integral, so our limits are going to be from 0 to t. However, you have to be careful on the left-hand side. When we made our substitution for u, all right, when v equals 0, u equals g, and our limits of integration then are not going to go from 0 to u. They're going to go from g to u. And by the way, this is only one way of doing it. There are a number of different ways that you can integrate this. So when you do integrate this, you come out with the ln of u minus the ln of g equals minus 3 pi mu d over m times t. And by the rule of logarithms, we can just say ln of u over g equals minus 3 pi mu d over mt. Now let's take both sides to the e. and multiply the other side, both sides by g. So that says that u equals g times e to the minus 3 pi mu d over mt. And so now we have a u as a function of t. We have to rewrite that u from our substitution that we did back here. So g minus 3 pi mu dv over m equals ge to the minus 3 pi mu d over m times t. And finally, we need to write this as v because we're looking for v of t. So we have to take all the rest of the terms on the left-hand side, get rid of them. And when we do that and simplify it, we end up with v of t equals mg 3 pi mu d 1 minus e to the minus 3 pi mu d over mt. Basically, I just added or subtracted the g from both sides, multiplied by minus m over 3 pi mu d, and then gathered like terms.